science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come, assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
Thank you.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself. The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now. I had to get inside the gas station to find a phone to call for help. The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
All right. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Candy-colored clown, they call the Sandman. Tiptoes to my room every night. And just a sprinkle of stardust and a whisper. Go to sleep, everything is all right. I close my eyes. Then I drift away into the
Previously on Alan Wake. I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice!
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at. But the cabin had disappeared.
Honey, I'm home.
Back here, sweetie. How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up. Hey, handsome. This is gonna be a long night, but these shots are turning out great.
I guess you're gonna need that coffee then. I'll go put it on.
Continuing freezing rain and heavy snowfall have necessitated a winter storm warning in the entire tri-state area. People are advised to stay indoors as many roadways are already closed, and city officials are not expecting snow crews to keep up with the weather. We're now on the third day of the blizzard, and the weather is not expected to clear up anytime soon.
Coffee's on.
Great, thanks. I'll need it if I'm gonna finish this by tomorrow. Oh, hey, I just finished those cover mock-ups. They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
No kidding. I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
These look really good.
Oh, sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called. Alan? Alan, please check the fuse box.
I'm right here. I'm on it, honey.
Please, hurry!
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
You okay?
Okay. I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
I know it's stupid, but it's just... especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay. I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you, too.
Yeah, nice story, Ryder boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
How do you feel, Mr. Wick? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that? Mr. Wake, how are you feeling?
I'm okay. My head's fine.
I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock. You should take it easy for a couple of days.
Thanks.
Well then, Mr. Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me. I'll let you get on with it then. Sarah, Sheriff Breaker, is waiting for you. She's very good at her job. I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time. I believe you'll find the sheriff in her office. Just go down the corridor.
I'm sorry you had to cut your morning fishing short for this, Doc.
Oh, she's a beauty, ain't she? Not the biggest I ever caught, if you can believe that coming from an old fisherman like me. But she's right up there. Now, she's a largemouth bass, which is what you're after if you prefer a lure. Now, if you want either trout or salmon, on the other hand, then it's fly fishing for you. You a fishing man, Mr. Wake? Oh, doesn't really matter, I suppose. But it can be very relaxing out there. You can't get me off the water this time of year. Closest thing to heaven.
I'll take your word for it, Doc.
You're good to go, Mr. Wake. Sarah's probably waiting for a chance to talk to you.
Mr. Wake, the sheriff is waiting for you in her office down the corridor. That was Cynthia Weaver. I guess you can call her the town eccentric. She used to be the editor of the local newspaper, but she's focused on, other things these days.
Yeah, it's Mulligan here. I'm at Stuckey's gas station with Thornton. There's no sign of him. Over.
Wait. Yeah, this is Thornton. Look, we've located the brake float. It's here. That's some good news, right? Stuckey was supposed to be driving it at the rehearsals today. Over.
Oh, give me that. Mulligan here. Looks like someone really thrashed the garage. Over.
Okay, roger that, guys. Keep looking for Stuckey. Jane's out.
The sheriff wants to see you in her office, Mr. Wake.
Come in, Mr. Wake. Your phone's on the desk. The battery was dead. It's charged now.
Have you started looking for my wife yet?
My men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
I'm not sure. I can't remember. We were arguing. I walked out of the cabin.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake?
How did you end up at Stuckey's gas station?
I wanted to tell her what had happened last night, but I couldn't. She'd lock me up. Excuse me, I need to take this. Hello?
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
Stop talking to the law. You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife.
Who is this?
Go to the back lot. There's a hole in the fence on the left. Look inside the junker. I left a little something there to convince you we're all on the same page here. After you ditch the cops, you're going to meet me in Elderwood National Park.
Mr. Wade, can I help you with anything?
There's a spot called Lover's Peak. Midnight. Don't do nothing stupid, pal. We're watching you.
Hey, mister! Hey, can you turn the lights on? The deputies, they don't understand. They won't listen to me. I need it to be bright in here. Thank you, man, thank you. Hey, you're all right. You're a good guy. Don't let anybody tell you different. You know, I shouldn't even be in here. The cops, they got it all wrong, see? Sure, I beat him up, but I wasn't drunk. I mean, I wasn't drunk at the time. I only got drunk afterward. Okay, listen. Listen, you gotta listen carefully now. Here's the kicker. That wasn't Danny. No, sir. It only looked like him. You wanna know who it really was? I'll tell you who it really was. It was a goddamn space alien! I know it sounded like something a drunk would say, but believe me, I wasn't drunk then. I told him, oh yeah, well, I don't hear.
The early morning light hurt my eyes and made my head ache. The man on the phone had said, go through the fence on the left.
Folks, it's been another long night, and it's about time for you to sign off. God knows I need my beer.
Alice's driver's license had been placed on the front seat. The caller meant business.
Barry?
Ow! Thank God! Where the hell have you been? I've been trying to reach you for a week, you and Alice. Oh, I've been worried sick. I flew out yesterday. I'm here in Bright Falls.
Barry, listen to me. I'm at the sheriff's station. Come and get me. I can't talk now.
Ow! What the hell is going on?
I had to get the sheriff to let me go. I needed to get to Elderwood National Park to meet Alice's kidnappers.
A writer is a light that reveals the world of his story from darkness, shapes it from nothingness. The way a sculptor carves a statue from a block of granite. If I stop, the world I'm making dies. Darkness will reclaim it. It's a long, hard journey into the dark. Alice's life is at stake, but I can't think about that, or I'll lose it. The dread lingers at the edge of perception. I'll push on. Anything is possible here. I'll write the story. I'll save her.
Marvelous, Sarah. I just wanted to settle all the damage the Anderson brothers might have inadvertently caused.
Are you feeling any better, Mr. Wake?
I'd like to leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about...
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know where you'll be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches. The cabins at Elderwood are pretty nice, though.
That sounds perfect.
I'm Dr. Emil Hartman. I'd like to invite you to stay at Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Did you talk to my wife?
I had the pleasure of discussing your situation with her on several occasions.
Did you set something up with her?
I invited her here. My clinic is a place where...
Oh!
Hey!
Oh my!
Take it easy.
Hey, nobody move! Get your hands off of my client!
Who are you?
I'm Barry Wheeler, his agent. If you have business with Mr. Wake, you talk to me. You yokels won't know what hit you once I sick my lawyers on your asses.
No harm done, Sarah. I'm all right. I don't want to press charges. Mr. Wake, my offer still stands.
Get me out of here.
What the hell was that about, Al? We don't need a replay of that thing with the paparazzi. I thought they were gonna lock you up.
I had to talk to someone. I told Barry everything. He thought I was certifiable, but when he heard about the manuscript, I had him. The fact that I'd written something, even if I couldn't remember it, was enough for him. He smelled money. And he believed that Alice had been kidnapped. Anything beyond that was another story. I had a midnight appointment with the kidnapper in a place called Lover's Peak, somewhere in Elderwood National Park. The plan was to rent a cabin.
I don't like it, Al. I don't like any of it. It's not good. In fact, it's the absolute opposite of good.
Mr. Wake! Barry, you found him.
Hi, Rose.
Oh, wow. I was just thinking about you, too.
Great.
I was just bringing Rusty some coffee. He's on the balcony, looking after Max. Poor thing. I really need to go. Great to see you again, Mr. Wake. Later!
Who's Max?
What an airhead.
Jeez, Mr. takes a swing at everybody. This is not her fault. She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan. She even has a fan site dedicated to you. And she was very helpful when I was looking for you. Seriously, Al, what you were saying in the car, just listen to
yourself. Wait here.
Easy there, boy. I'm almost done.
Hey, Rusty, right? You rent cabins.
Oh, Mr. Wake. I'd shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay, sure. What happened?
What, you shot a guy and his body just disappeared? When was the last time you slept? Are you high? Have you been drinking?
No! Look, Barry, I'm missing a week. And someone's got Alice.
Do you understand what it sounds like when you say stuff like that?
Wait here.
I think this is the form you wanted.
And here are the keys. Okay, you're all set, Mr. Wake. Glad to have you staying here.
Thanks. Can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Seriously, Al, you can't just go and meet a kidnapper. Those situations always end up in disaster. Just crazy talk, Al. Al? Al? We should go to the sheriff or call the FBI.
Damn it, Barry. They'll kill her.
This is not a goddamn debate, Barry. I'm going to Lover's Peak. He said to come alone.
Okay then. I understand. You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head. Tell me what to do to help, and I'll do it.
You stay here, and if I'm not back by morning, call the cavalry.
Achoo!
Just be careful with the natives, Al. These yokels are dangerous. Everybody hates a tourist, or it'll be deliverance all over again.
Achoo!
I'll hold down the fort. I'll be with you in spirit every step of the way, Al. Walk through the door now.
I knew I should have gone to the cops. This wasn't the smartest thing I'd ever done, but I was still angry with Barry for trying to talk me out of it. These people had called me right in the sheriff's station. The cops wouldn't scare them, and they had Alice.
Welcome back to the show, folks. As promised, our very own Dr. Nelson has just parked his rear end in the studio. Doc, what's your Deerfest plan like?
My plan? You'll make it sound a lot more organized than I ever seem to manage. No plan, really. Just taking the atmosphere. I'm getting a little too rickety to do much more than that.
Tell me about it. No sack race for us older gentlemen, huh?
answer and cure of civilization. But some crimes are impossible to punish, especially in Night Springs. Tonight's episode, The Man in the Mirror.
The way it was on that page. I found. Came true. It knew. So dark. It'll come back for me. You must. The lights. In the office. I have the key.
Okay, Rusty. Hang on. I'll be right back. Whatever did this couldn't be far. Rusty had found a page from the manuscript. It would help me understand what had happened. Shh. Good boy. The only way to make sure that Rusty was safe was to get the power running and the lights back on. Someone had destroyed the circuit breaker. There was no way to get the lights back on.
Rusty!
The ground was covered with burning patches that looked like liquid darkness. Sized hole in the wall.
Please!
Don't feed the animals!
Fishing
is only permitted
for those
visitors
who purchase a park
fishing
license. Obey
the park ranger's instructions
at all times.
Rusty, no!
Never!
Never approach them when they're charged.
Two bears and wolves, never approach any other
wildlife
closer than
25 yards.
That's awesome!
At all times.
Never leave your
head unattended.
Forget about it, Barry. It's just me going crazy.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. You're not crazy. I wish you were crazy, but you're not crazy. Ow, be careful.
Stay in the cabin. Don't open the door for anyone. I mean it.
Lover's Peak was at the far end of the nature trail.
Thank you.
We gotta get moving. More of them coming. That flashlight's kid stuff. The flares will keep the bastards away.
You can see them too?
Hell, of course I see them. Come on, we gotta move.
Why?
Because that's the way the story goes.
Yeah, but...
Let's move!
I lost my gun back there.
Oh, I've got a gun. Just keep that light steady on him.
It took a moment, but then I recognized him. He'd been on the ferry when I first arrived here with Alice. He knew my name. We were headed in the direction of Lover's Peak. There was no way this was a coincidence. He was the kidnapper.
Come on, Wake! You better keep up! From the emergency box to hold them off while I get these boards off.
Give me the gun.
Yeah, no can do, Wake.
Are you kidding? Give me the gun!
No time for back talk. Hold them off, damn it! Just a little longer. Scare them off. Get some light on those bastards. That'll keep them off us. Just a little longer. I almost got it. Okay, it's open. Move it or lose it. That's right. You just keep coming. Oh, you're feeling better now, Wake. All cozy and safe.
Better get ready. They'll be on us soon.
This is it, Wake. Last stand. There's more players here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun! They're coming!
That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
Monster!
Let's cut the act now. Where's my wife?
I knew you were gonna say that. I read it all before. You're a hell of a writer. Congratulations. You're gonna bring about something glorious and terrible once we get you some proper editorial control.
What the hell are you talking about? Where's Alice?
I want the entire manuscript, or she's gonna suffer bad.
You touch her off. Kill you if you hurt Alice! Do you hear me? Come back here!
He had Alice, and he wanted the manuscript because he thought it held some magical power. But I had no manuscript to give him. I had to get back to Barry and figure out my next move.
be aware of what you wish. Occupation!
first. They've got all Hitchcock on me.
Stay out of sight. I'm on my way. Don't open the door.
What, am I crazy?
Stay hidden. I'll be there soon. Just make sure you keep the lights on. I still had to reach Barry at the cap, but at least I was out of the woods. I'd have to get the car from the locked garage. It would get me back to Barry faster, and the headlights were a welcome bonus. I had to find the key to the garage.
A story is not a machine that does what you tell it. A story is a beast with a life of its own. You can create it, shape it, but as the story grows, it starts wanting things of its own. Change one thing and you set off a chain reaction of events that spreads through the whole thing. The characters have to be true to themselves. The events need to follow a logic that fits the story. A single flaw and the magic is gone. The story dies. Alice dies.
The flare gun was probably the best weapon I could imagine against the dark things I was facing. It was the kidnapper.
You son of a bitch! Where's my wife?
Enough horseplay, Wake! You deliver the manuscript, and you can have your woman back. Simple as that.
I don't... Listen. Listen. I'm gonna need time to finish it. I still need to write the ending. I need... a week.
Not done?
I need a week.
2 days! The old Bright Falls coal mine is nearby. You can find it easy, city boy. The main building, there at noon. You bring the manuscript, you'll get your wife. If not, well, get me.
Yes, yes, I get you.
Barry had talked about birds over the phone.
Al! Al, I am so glad you're here. A couple of them got in here before I blocked the chimney. This isn't normal. These birds are weird.
Thank you.
door now. They're gone.
Hey, Al. I'm sorry for thinking you were having a psychotic episode, man.
I sent Barry to the town to ask around about a man fitting the kidnapper's description. He'd go through the archives of the local paper. Perhaps he could learn something. Anything about the island and the cabin that had disappeared. The man wanted a manuscript. I had to try to write him one to get Alice back. For me, the supernatural had always been nothing but a metaphor for the human psyche, a tool to use in writing fiction. Now, it was happening for real, and I couldn't put a single word on paper.
Barry Wheeler speaking.
This is Rose.
Rose?
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Oh, you sweet, brilliant girl.
Could you and Mr. Wake come get them? I live in the trailer park outside the town.
We'll be there in less than an hour.
I know.
See you soon.
Have a great day. Hope you come back soon.
Welcome to the Old Deer Diner.
Good girl.
Previously on Alan Wake, Alice has been kidnapped.
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
I can't tell anyone except my agent, Barry.
Damn it, Barry, they'll kill her.
You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head.
The ransom is a manuscript I supposedly wrote that's coming true before my eyes.
It happened just the way it was on that page. So dark.
I have found only a few scattered pages.
I want the entire manuscript.
The deadline is in 2 days.
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Good girl.
How the hell did she get her hands on the manuscript anyway?
I don't know. She's resourceful. I told you you were too hard on her. Listen, I found out all sorts of interesting stuff while I was digging around.
Yeah.
Mr. Wake, it's Sheriff Breaker. We have an FBI agent here, Agent Nightingale.
FBI?
He's anxious to see you. You'd better come to the station.
Okay, I'll be right over, Sheriff. Let's make this quick, huh?
Help you folks? Name's Randolph. I'm the manager.
We're looking for Rose. Works as a waitress down at the diner.
Rose, sure. Nice girl. Who wants to know?
I'm Alan Wake.
The writer, huh? I heard on the radio you were visiting. Well, I'll show you her trailer. That Rose, she's a nice girl. Always pays her rent on time.
As I was saying, Al, I found all sorts of weird stuff from the local newspaper's archives. This place is crazy! Disappearances, mysterious deaths, urban legends come true, and, get this, most of this stuff takes place around Cauldron Lake.
Well, you ain't wrong, mister. The Indians thought the lake was a doorway to the underworld. I'm the God-fearing type myself. I don't hold with that sort of thing.
Yeah, okay. Anyway, there was an island there owned by a guy called Thomas Zane. Now, some of the articles I found about him make him out to be a famous writer, but I ran a bunch of searches, couldn't find a single thing he wrote. Zane was heavily into diving, so much so that the place came to be called Diver's Isle. But the volcano under the lake erupted in 1970, and Zane went down with the island. gets better. A local girl, Barbara Jagger, drowned in Cauldron Lake just a week earlier. They were lovers.
Sure, Jagger's a local spook store. The Scratching Hag comes for you in the dark. Childish stuff like that.
Anyway, Al, I'm just getting to the best part. All of the articles about this stuff were written by Cynthia Weaver. I asked around, and she's that crazy bag lady you met.
What, the lamp lady? She can be a little loopy, but she's not homeless or anything.
Yeah, anyway, she knew both Jagger and Zane before they both died, and she had some kind of a breakdown.
Well, mister, this here's Rose's trailer. You mind me asking what you want with her?
We're just here to talk to her, pal.
Welcome to... Oh dear, Mr. Wake. I'm so glad you're here.
Rose, you have my manuscript?
Oh. Oh, yes. Yes. Please, come in.
Hey, this is really good.
Rose.
Yes.
My manuscript. I really need it.
I understand. I know what you need. A muse to inspire you.
Oh, for Barry. She doesn't have anything.
Yeah. Hey, Al. Oh, what's... Oh...
Barry! What?
It's coming for you. Hiding in my barber's skin. I'm too weak to stop it. You must turn the lights on.
I promised I'd come visit you and your lovely wife. You must finish what you started. I insist.
You must turn the lights on. Turn the light on.
I felt nauseous, hungover. Only anger kept me going.
I can't tell reality.
Rose took a day from me. I had less than 12 hours left to meet the kidnapper. All I could do was get Barry into the car, work something out once I got on the road. My gun and flashlight were gone. I'd have to find a way to get Barry into the car as quickly as possible. There was no time to waste.
I just stepped outside to catch a breath of fresh air. Let me tell you, the weather's getting heavy. Nights like this make me especially glad I'm here talking to you.
You're gonna get it now.
God knows what you've done to that poor girl.
This is Agent Nightingale, FBI! Get him up, Hemingway! You're under arrest! You move a muscle, I'll unload right in your goddamn face! Stay right where you are, Spillane!
Right here, you goddamn maniac!
hated to leave Barry behind, but there was no way I'd miss my appointment with the kidnapper. This horror was everywhere I went, circling me. The cops didn't stand a chance. They were after a writer, not a monster.
Give me that. Jane, Mulligan here. Over. Go ahead, Mulligan. Over. We got Wheeler and Rose here. Wheeler's drunk or hopped up on something. Speaking of which, that Fed had a pretty distinctive whiff of eau de scotch about him.
I imagine that the broadcast tower in the distance was part of the local radio station. Main seemed like a decent guy. Perhaps he could give me directions to the coal mine. Unnatural shadows clung to the gate. The darkness that was after me was trying to stop me. I wouldn't get through without a light. Generator conked out. I'd have to see if I could fix it and try again. It took me a moment to recognize the flashbang grenades. They were an ideal weapon for my situation.
Team 1, come in. Over. Team 1, this is Sheriff Breaker. Report, over.
And here's another call. You're on KBFFN with Pat Main.
It's Milt Peabody, Pat.
What's on your mind, Milt?
Well, I live near the trailer park, Pat, and there's a big ruckus going on over there.
I hope Maine could lend me a car to get to the coal mine.
Come on in, Mr. Wake.
Oh, I'm so glad you could find the time to do this, Mr. Wake.
Nowhere to run now, Dan Brown. You back away from me. Don't hurt.
Whoa. Everyone calm down. Put the gun down. We're all friends here, right?
Cool your jets, Nightingale. We got him.
Jesus, priest.
What the hell's the matter with you? There's a civilian in there.
I had fallen off so many cliffs it was ridiculous. That's what you get for naming a book The Sudden Stop. It was probably good I hadn't had the chance to tell Maine where I was going. I'd have to lose the cops and find my own way to the mine.
Oh.
There was no sensible reason for the power company work lights to be here. It was almost as if they'd been left for someone like me to use.
Hello?
The most stubborn man I've ever met.
Alice? Alice?
Alan. I'm so afraid. It keeps me in the dark. Please help me. I look at you, Alan, and it's not you. It's something else. Looking out from behind your eyes.
Alice, I'm here.
I'm so alone. All gonna go to hell. You need to be careful. Cooperate.
The connection had been terrible, but that wasn't the only thing that hadn't been right with the call. She sounded wrong somehow, but she had called me. I could see a railway bridge up ahead, and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there.